If you would enter into the wilderness, do not begin without a blessing. Do not leave without hearing who you are. Beloved, named by the one who has traveled this path before you. Do not go without letting it echo into your ears. And if you find it is hard to let it into your heart, do not despair. This is what the journey is for. I cannot promise this blessing will free you from danger, from fear, from hunger or thirst, from the scorching of the sun or the fall of the night. But I can tell you that on this path there will be help. I can tell you that on this way there will be rest. I can tell you we'll know the strange graces that come to our aid, and only on a road such as this, that fly to meet us bearing comfort and strength, that come alongside us for no other cause than to lean themselves toward our ear, and with their curious insistence, whisper our name. Beloved, beloved, beloved. Hello and welcome to a contemplative service in the style of Tezay. My name is Carrie Grace Litauer, and I am delighted to hold this space for us today. I'm joined by Kester Limner and Andy Myers, two musicians and parishioners at St. Andrew's Episcopal Church in Seattle, Washington. A big thank you to St. Andrew's for making this virtual service possible. And thank you for joining us for this Lenten season. This past Wednesday was Ash Wednesday, and this is the first Sunday in Lent, where we follow in the steps of Jesus, who went into the wilderness for 40 days and was tempted. The poem I read to open for us was Belovedness is Where We Begin by Jan Richardson. Blessed be God, creator, redeemer, and spirit of love. And blessed be God's beloved community, now and forever. Grace to you and peace from God, our creator, the love at our beginning and without end, in our midst and with us now. God is with us. Here we find new life.
Not a detour, not a
Now let us take a moment to move more deeply into silence and resting in the presence of the Holy One. Living Spirit, whose breath gives life to the world and whose voice is heard in the soft breeze, we need your strength and wisdom. Come breathe among us and within us. Gather us with your whole creation as together we embody the transforming love of Christ Jesus, our Redeemer. Amen. And now a reading from the Gospel of Luke. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become a loaf of bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone."
out for peace, Lord. We cry out for an end to war and suffering. We pray for bravery. We pray for faith. Oh Lord, we pray. Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison. Bring your Holy Spirit to the people of Ukraine. Bring your Holy Spirit to the people of Afghanistan. Bring your Holy Spirit to the people of Syria, Ethiopia, Libya, Iraq, and Myanmar. Be with those who suffer from war all around the world. Oh Lord, we pray, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison. For children who are trapped by violence, be their comfort. For families and college students who are escaping war, be their hope. For those who have lost everything, God, be the treasure of their souls. Oh Lord, we pray, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison. For young soldiers who don't know why they are fighting, be their internal voice of conscience. For world leaders who act out of pride and bitterness or greed, be the hand of justice for their victims. Oh Lord, we pray, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison. For those who stand up for truth at great personal cost, be their strength and their reward. For those who sacrifice their lives for those they love, be the keeper of their souls. For those who are walking bravely into the darkness, be their light. Oh Lord, we pray, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison. We ask, O Lord, that you would guide our prayers and our hearts. Be with those who have died and those who are dying. Show us how to grieve. Show us how to pray. Show us how to follow you. Oh Lord, we pray, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison.
At this time, I invite you into offering your individual prayers of intercession. Please feel free to pray with me, and if you have any candles, you can light them as well. Come, let us offer our hearts to the Holy One. Let us pray. And now would you pray with me the Lord's Prayer? This version that we use is from the New Zealand Book of Prayer. Eternal Spirit, Earth Maker, Pain Bearer, Life Giver, Source of all that is and that shall be, Father and Mother of us all, loving God, in whom is heaven. The hallowing of your name echo through the universe. The way of your justice be followed by the peoples of the world. Your heavenly will be done by all created beings. Your commonwealth of peace and freedom sustain our hope and come on earth. With the bread we need for today, feed us. In the hurts we absorb from one another, forgive us. In times of temptation and test, strengthen us. From trial too great to endure, spare us. From the grip of all that is evil, free us. For you reign in the glory of the power that is love, now and forever. Amen. Well, as we join together in this Lenten journey in the wilderness, in this quiet time of fasting and prayer and contemplation, I'm reminded of, or I came across these words by Suzanne Guthrie, an Episcopal priest, when she said of Lent, "Fasting widens the boundaries of compassion, stretches the heart, makes room for love." Lent is meant to expand our capacity to love. So I hope that this season of fasting can be one that stretches you and makes room for more love in your lives. I have a poem from Steve Garnes Holmes in reflection on the verse that I read today. The verse in Luke that says, where the devil says to Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become a loaf of bread." And Jesus answers, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone." And Pastor Steve says to us, "So much we are hungry for that does not feed us. So many stones we wish we could turn to bread. Call them to mind. Hold these stones in your hand. Feel their gray mass, their lightless insides, the weight of disappointment, the hard edges of refusal, the dense failure to satisfy. You can't change them. Cease gnawing on them. Let them be stones. Set them down. In the breeze, feel the breath of the present one, moving among the unmoving stones, light and sweet. Let yourself be nourished by that wind, freely flowing, invisible, rich with grace, thick with energy. Even among the hungering stones, the Spirit lives. Even in barren places, love offers its merciful bread." Amen. Well, as always, it is a true joy to worship with you, to hold this space with and for you, and thank you for joining us. I hope that this virtual service can be a source of deepening and nourishment in this Lenten journey. Please feel free to share this service with others with the link or comment on our YouTube page. We'd love to hear from you. And now a blessing for the journey. The peace of the living Christ be always with you. Let us go forth bearing God's peace to the world. Thanks be to God. Thank you.
May we see